Hello students, welcome again in our today's video lesson. The last video lesson we have completed up to this an online class about the chemical formula and elements, the atomicity, monoatomic, and we have also done the charts. In today's video lesson, we'll start from this about the compounds. So today's topic is compounds. Okay. So what are compounds? Compound means they are also pure substance. Compounds are also called as pure substance, which are formed. So we can say that compounds are formed of, they are pure substance formed by the combination of two or more elements in fixed proportion. Okay, so the pure substance formed by the combination of two or more elements in a fixed proportion, they are called compounds. So for example, if you take the example that given in your book also, that is water. So water is made up of what? As all of you know, this is hydrogen plus oxygen. It makes water. So water is a pure substance because this hydrogen and oxygen combined together in the ratio, fixed ratio, that is 2:1 ratio. So hydrogen and oxygen combined together is 2:1 ratio. So every molecule of water, in every molecules of water, it contains two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Similarly, if you take carbon dioxide, here also carbon and oxygen, they combine together in the ratio 1:2. So its formula is CO2, all of you know, carbon dioxide, and water is H2O. So two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. Similarly, in carbon dioxide also, one atom of carbon and two atoms of oxygen. Similarly, if you take nitrogen dioxide, it is also NO2, so that means it contains nitrogen plus oxygen, it is in also 1:2 ratio. So there are so many compounds known to us, and compounds are generally elements are represented by chemical formula. No, so they are represented by chemical symbols. But more compounds are represented by chemical formula. Okay, so that's why water, carbon dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, there are enormous number of formulas are there. So, and one more thing that we have to see in the characteristics of these compounds, that the compound that formed after the combination of two or more elements in fixed proportion, the property of this compound form is totally different from the properties of the constituent elements. Suppose if you take here, hydrogen is a gaseous, it is in gaseous state, oxygen is also a gas. But when it forms water, it is a liquid. Okay? So the property is totally different. Some more property, hydrogen is very explosive gas. Oxygen helps in burning, whereas water helps to put off fire. Okay, So these are the property of compound is totally different from the property of the constituent elements that are used to form a compound. Okay. So similarly, each and every compound, the property is quite different from the constituent elements. But the main thing is that compounds are generally formed by represented by chemical formula. Compounds are represented by chemical formulae. Okay, formulae. Okay, the plural of formula is formulae. So compounds are represented by chemical formulae. Now, the next point is valency. What is valency? Valency means the number of, it means the number of atoms present in one present in a molecule of a compound, okay, and it also means the combining capacity, okay, the combining, or you can say combining capacity of the elements forming the compound. When elements combine together to form a compound, so that the number of atoms present in each and every element to form a compound, to form one molecule of a compound, that is called valency. So simply we can say that the combining capacity of an atom of an element is called valency. The simple definition, you can, by combining these two statements, you can simply say that the combining capacity, ultimately we can, the definition can, we can say that combining capacity of an atom of an element. Okay. So simply you can say that combining capacity of an atom of an element is called the valency. So the valency of different elements are different. If the valency of an element is 1, it is called monovalent. If the valency is 2, then it is called divalent. Suppose the valency of hydrogen, if I take simple element, hydrogen, its valency is 1, which is called monovalent. Okay. Similarly, the oxygen valency of oxygen is 2, it is called divalent. Okay. Similarly, if you take aluminium, its valency is 3, so it is called trivalent. It is called trivalent. Okay. So each and every element have a valency. Sometimes some elements also having more than one valency, then they are called as variable valency. Okay. So the chart is given in your book that some of the examples are lithium, sodium, potassium and hydrogen are monovalent, they have valency 1. Oxygen, magnesium, zinc have valency 2, it's called divalent. Boron, aluminium is having 3 valency, that's called trivalent. Carbon and silicon have 4 valency, they are called tetravalent. Nitrogen, phosphorus, they have 2 valencies, 3 and 5, so they are called variable valencies. Sulfur is having also 3 valency, 3, 2, 4, 6, that is also variable valency. So similar, so many elements have more than one valency, in that case, they are called as variable valency. You need to learn these things, okay? You have to learn valency. When you will learn the valency, then after you can be able to make derive the chemical formula. Okay, so in this class, video lesson, we will do up to this. The next video lesson, I will show you how to write a chemical formula. And if you learn these charts only, then you can only be able to write the chemical formula. Otherwise, if you don't know valency, you will be not able to write chemical formula. Okay, students, see you. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the online class and video class. Thank you very much.